Operational amplifiers are one of the most commonly used electronic devices today. They're considered to be one of the basic building blocks of analog electronic circuits. Op-amps are linear devices that can provide close to ideal DC amplification, making them an excellent choice for signal conditioning, filtering, and even mathematical operations. An op-amp is a type of differential amplifier. One of their most common uses is for signal voltage amplification, and that is what the lab will focus on. An op-amp's inputs typically consist of a non-inverting input, usually marked with a plus symbol, and an inverting input, usually marked with a minus symbol. Ideally, the op-amp amplifies only the difference between the two inputs, which is called the differential input voltage. The output voltage of the op-amp is represented by the following equation. Vout is equal to AOL times the difference between the inverting and non-inverting inputs, where AOL is the open loop gain of the amplifier. Open loop refers to the absence of a feedback loop from the output to the input. This feedback loop is typically achieved with a resistor. The open loop gain of an op-amp is typically very large, usually a factor of 100,000 or more for integrated circuit op-amps. This means that very small differences between the two inputs will drive the amplifier output nearly to the supply voltage, which is as high as it can go. These conditions where the output voltage is equal to or greater than the supply voltage are referred to as saturation of the amplifier. Because the exact magnitude of the op-amp's gain is not well controlled by the manufacturing process, it's impractical to use an op-amp as a standalone differential amplifier. Op-amps configured without negative feedback are referred to as comparators. To achieve a more reliable and predictable magnitude of gain from an op-amp, negative feedback is used. This negative feedback is achieved by applying a portion of the output voltage to the inverting input. This is called closed loop feedback, and it greatly reduces the gain of the circuit. When negative feedback is used, the circuit's overall gain is now determined mostly by the feedback network rather than the op-amp's characteristics. This effectively eliminates manufacturing differences of the op-amp and allows for a predictable and repeatable factor of gain in the circuit. An op-amp of some type can be found in just about every piece of electronic equipment. They're widely used in audio and video preamplifiers and buffers. Op-amps are also used as differentiators and integrators, filters, rectifiers, and regulators. Op-amps are also critical components in analog-to-digital converters, as well as digital-to-analog converters. An important design feature of many op-amps is a standardized pinout that allows one type to be swapped for another without having to make difficult wiring changes,